it's Jen. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to break down the process that I use to build my six-figure online coaching business. So if you want to transfer your service-based professional business online into a coaching business, this video is going to be valuable for you. I used this process basically to build a very lucrative coaching business. And last year, I was actually awarded Innovator of the Year out of 550 business coaches based on what I'm gonna be sharing with you right now. So the first step is to take an inventory of the gifts and talents that you already have. You already have skills, you already have knowledge, you already have expertise. And you may be working for someone else or working in a business model for yourself, and the model is just broken. It's just not working out to be what you expected it to be. And so the first place that we want to start it with is what you already can do. What do you already know, and what outcome can you provide to people that you know can serve them at a high level? And then you ask yourself, how do I take this knowledge and skill set and transfer it online? Because really the only difference between having a service-based business that's mainly done in person and then doing it online is really the technology. So, and those issues can be worked out. And in another video, I'll share with you the technology that I use to run my online coaching business. In this video, I just want to stay focused on the general strategy. All right, so you have your gifts and talents, you have the big idea, the outcome that you can provide for clients, and then you decide that you're going to transfer it to an online coaching business. The first concept that I think you'll need to get is understanding the big why behind your online coaching business. What is it that you're looking for? For me, my big why was freedom. I came from a corporate background. I was a corporate marketing executive working for brands like NASA, at Kennedy Space Center, ABC Television, Big Pharma. You know, I had been there, done that, and checked all the boxes on a resume for corporate America. And I just basically hit that proverbial glass ceiling in that I really felt like my skill set was being undervalued and I wasn't being paid what I was worth. The other issue that I had with working in corporate work was lack of individual freedom over my schedule and over my time schedule. And I remember I would come into work at 7 a.m. and leave at 6, and the big boss would say, "Where are you going, Jen? You're working a half day today?" And I know he was basically joking. He was kind of joking, but on the other hand, there was a very serious statement behind that. And I just didn't want to feel chained to my desk, and I didn't want to feel chained to a company. I wanted to be able to control how I worked, when I worked, where I worked, and who I worked with, and for how much money. So for me, that was my big why, was freedom. And you'll need to tap into that for yourself. Maybe your big why is that you want to be able to stay home with your kids. I don't have kids, so that wasn't my why. My why was personal freedom. But maybe yours is you want to be able to stay home with your kids. So you have to just tap into that, because it isn't easy to build an online business no matter what the gurus tell you. And you'll want to come back to that moment. You'll want to come back to that reason and come back to that why to keep you motivated. The second area, the second key strategy that I think you need to know is the big problem that you solve for your clients. Being very specific about the avatar or the client demographic. The more clear you are on who you serve, the easier the entire business model will become. Let's say that you're a coach and you work with small business owners and leaders, executive leaders that manage teams, and you want to help them build better teams. So you would need to stay focused on that and realize that your message and all of your marketing needs to be related to professionals that have teams underneath them and not general professionals or general business owners, because not every business owner has a team. They don't have people that work for them. Many business owners are solopreneurs, or maybe they have one or two support staff. And so for them, team building isn't going to be a major problem that they're solving. So the more clear you are on the person that you help and the problem that you help them solve, everything will become a lot easier. The other concept that I want to talk about in building an online coaching business is that there really are three key areas of life that people pay for coaching. Number one is health, number two is wealth, and number three is relationships. So if you can help someone improve their health, maybe you're a fitness coach or a nutritionist or a wellness provider, that is a great area to have an online coaching business. Or maybe you can help people make money as a business coach or as a marketer. That is a really lucrative field right now. Or you help people save money. Maybe you help them as a wealth manager. You help them with retirement planning. That is a really key hot area in online coaching right now. So health and wealth, and then relationships. Relationships can include personal development, which means their relationship with themselves, but it can also be relationships like love coaching, marriage coaching, relationship coaching, relationships that they have with other people in their lives. So health, wealth, and relationships are the three key hot areas for online coaching right now. The third key area, the key strategy that you're gonna need to know as you build an online coaching business is to find a mentor. Pick a mentor and stick with them and follow their system. I see a lot of new coaches jumping around, consuming a lot of content and information from lots of different coaches. And the reality is that every coach has their own unique way of building their business. Some coaches have built it with speaking. Some people have built it with webinars. Some people have built it with Facebook ads. Some people have built them with magazines. Some people have built their coaching business with Facebook groups and building a community or networking or whatever. And there are lots of different ways to build an online coaching business. You need to find the coach that makes the most sense for you, that you like their marketing strategy, that they are actually doing the marketing strategy that they tell you to do, and that you kind of get them, you vibe with them on a personal level. But pick a coach, pick a strategy, and stay with them. Don't coach jump, I call it. Don't jump around from coach to coach to coach, consuming information and trying a lot of different things. Pick one strategy and work that strategy, work that system until it works. The last thing that I want to talk about on how to build an online coaching business is you need to become an online marketing master. The value in your business is not in your genius. The value in your business is in your ability to market your genius. Truth. And if you cannot master the online marketing, you're going to have a really hard time building your online coaching business. I think there are four key areas that have worked for me with online marketing that I would highly recommend you check out and consider becoming a master at. Number one is speaking and webinars. The key component to my success as an online business coach has been in the power of my strategic partners. Back here on my magazine, you see my strategic partner, Leah from Smartfem Media Group. She has a growing community. She has a conference that she does every year. And that relationship has been invaluable to me as a coach because I could partner with her and provide information, knowledge, skill set, and expertise to her community as a value add, as a member of the community. Find strategic partners and help their community. The best way to do that is by speaking at their events or speaking on webinars that they host for their community, or even just doing Facebook Live videos to their group. That is a key component to having success as an online coach. You'll need to be able to communicate the value, communicate your message, and connect it to people that need to hear it. And strategic partners will give you access to their already built group and their already built community without you having to start from scratch. And then when the people in that community resonate with you and your message, they'll jump over and join your community and your list and your social channels. And strategic partners are a very great way to build your online coaching business fast. The other concept that I'll talk about that I think is really highly important is for you to be seen as an authority in your space, in your industry. Writing a book or publishing your own magazine is a very key strategy that almost all experts have. I've actually written four books. I'm writing my fifth one now, but I will have to say that books take a lot of investment. They take a lot of time, and they do take some expenditure of money and energy. So just be aware of that. I have had great success with my magazine funnels, which have given me the notoriety just as a book. But the cool thing about having a magazine is that I'm in control of the sales process. When I publish my books, I just put them on Amazon, and I didn't have any control over knowing who was buying the book or where the email address was for the purchaser of the Amazon book. And so I like to own my audience, and I created a magazine that I could sell online or give away online. on my system, on my funnel, and that helped me build my email list really, really quickly. So you'll need an asset like a book or a magazine that will help you build your authority and be seen as a credible expert, but also be very much paying attention to building your list and building your email database of your ideal perfect people. The reality is that 99% of the people that see your marketing messages for your online coaching business are not going to be what we call now buyers, meaning they're not going to pick up the phone and call you right away for a consultation or to join your membership program or to join your group or get advice from you. They're just not. That's not how they buy. So the power of your online coaching business and the value in it is in your email list. So build your email list. The other area that you need to become an online marketing master for is social media. So you will need to own your platforms. If your ideal perfect clients, your avatar, are hanging out on Facebook, you need to become a Facebook marketing master. If your people are hanging out on LinkedIn, you need to become a LinkedIn marketing master. It's just what it is. And so if you're having a hard time attracting people into your online coaching business, it's probably because your marketing is broken somewhere along the line. Either your avatar isn't clearly defined, your message isn't clearly defined, or the media that you're sharing your message on isn't the right media for you and your people. So those are the four areas you need to become an online marketing master for: speaking with webinars and live events and partnering with strategic partners to help you grow your audience, authority marketing by having a magazine or a book, and social media marketing and email marketing to build your list and build your audience. So those are the four key strategies. I hope that this has been beneficial to you and giving you some clarity on what you need to focus on next as you build your online coaching business. If it's been valuable, please give me a like or hit the subscribe button to make sure that you are aware of all of the new videos as they are released. I release a new video every Wednesday on low-cost, high-impact marketing strategies that will grow your business without breaking the bank. All right, so thanks for tuning in. I'll see you on the next video.